come to the last thing, and we will now test the discriminant validity of our script. So what will I do? I will now create a new file, and I will call this as measurement. I will save it as okay. So now I have measurement. Now I want to bring all my constructs together. So I just do edit, copy. So I select and I select all. I say copy, okay, and then I go to this measurement model and I say paste. Okay, so you see this has pasted, and I deselect this. Then I want to bring my second construct. Yes, I will save this, and now I want to bring procedural justice. So I select all, I say edit. Say copy, then go to measurement model and I say edit, paste. And now, because this is selected, others are not selected, you can move it to whichever position you and deselect everything. Then go to the third construct, save this. Third construct, we are going to work with the pool model. So select all and say edit, copy. And then go to measurement model and say edit. And because only this one is selected, others are deselected, just move this to the place where you want to. Okay. Now, what have we done? We have brought all these three together. And I now first want to test the discriminant validity. So I will allow them to, I will test the correlations between these constructs. Okay. And I will change these, make them look nice and beautiful. Okay. So I have these three constructs now. I have leadership, I have PJ, and I have CP, right? I save this model. I go to my analysis properties. I do the same thing, qualification indices. I have now all these together, okay? And I run the, this becomes my overall measurement model. I have not specified a data file. Yes, I forgot to do that. So let me do that here. And I have assigned the data file. And now I will save this and run. Now you see my run has happened. Now you see individually we were getting very clean model. But now when we bring all of them together, the chi-square is 206 and degrees of freedom is 127. I told you that when we have complex models, even if constructs are doing well, what will happen is that the chi-square test fails, right? So what happens is, in that case, we look at what happens to our alternate fit index. Now you see the chi-square is, p-value is less than 0.05, but our chi-square by DF is less than 2. So this is actually a good index, it is passing. GFI is 0.96, it is passing. CFI is 0.985, it is passing as well. And RMSEA is also very small, it is 0.03. So Now at this stage, when I have made a complex model, I have brought all of my constructs together. I don't want to make any changes to my model, and therefore in my paper, I will now take the support of alternate fit indices, report that all of them, not even one is failing, all of them are passing alternate fit indices, and therefore I will continue to believe that this is a good fitting. This model fits with the data there. And this is perfectly accepted in literature that even if your chi-squared test is not passing, but your alternate fit indices, that is why alternate fit indices have been invented. If your alternate fit indices are passing, and remember, all of them are giving you good result, all of them, then it is perfectly fine and people will accept your result as good and accepted. Okay. If you have, if you want to sort of see what can be done at this stage, you will get fit indices. But believe me, and the kind of fit indices that you will get here will make no sense. So let us look at fit indices. The biggest drop is here, and it says E16. Should co-vary with this. That means co-vary leadership with E16. Well, for me, this makes no sense at all. Okay. And similarly, if you look at other fit indices, it will make no sense. I actually, at this stage, I don't do anything. How do I go about my analysis? I look at construct by construct, and I ensure that I am getting good fit for each construct. So I'm getting good fit for leadership, I'm getting good fit for PJ, I'm getting good fit for creativity, and therefore when I bring this all together, I am very sure that the chi-square may fail, but my other fit indices will pass, and therefore I let them remain as it is. I don't make any changes at all. I consider this to be acceptable, and the research literature also believes that this is perfectly fine. Chi-square test tends to fail when you start making your models. Some people say chi-square fails because of sample size. That is not true. In my experience, chi-square test fails when you have complex models. Okay? So we have brought these three constructs together. And now what we want to do is we want to do the discriminant analysis. For that, what we will do is we will just copy. We will not do it. We'll take a break here. But what I do is, we'll copy this standardized loadings, and we will go to our Excel. We will open a new sheet and we'll call this as discriminant validity test for constructs. Okay, we will paste it here, right? And we will go and do similar things that we did yesterday. We will say lambda. We will say lambda to the power 2. Then we will have 1 minus lambda square. Then we will have ABE. We will have CR. Okay. And we will insert 2 lines after every construct. Okay, so we will save this and we'll come back and do this. This is what we defined as error variance. And now we will test the discriminancy of the construct measured through R scale with the other. So let us stop here. We'll come back and do the discipline and validity test. We'll take a 15-minute break, so we'll come back by around 7. Okay, so Surabhi, to your question, what it means is that the variance, okay, how do you get an estimate of the variance of the measurement error? Variance of measurement error is anything that is uniquely attached to that item, okay, unique to that item. And unique to that item is the individual variance of that item. What it shares with the other, what is common with the other items, is the covariance. And therefore, we assume that the variance of the measurement error can be crudely approximated to the variance of the individual item. And therefore, the total measurement error would be equal to the sum of variance of each of the individual items. So that is what it means, that when you are looking at let me just open that presentation and to your question on reliability. Yeah. So this sigma 1 square, sigma 2 square and sigma 3 square is the variance of the item that is not shared with other items. And therefore this uniqueness of the item is actually an estimate. See, if otherwise what would have happened, what should have happened, that everything should have been correlated to other items. And that is what is getting captured in reliability. So this is the shared variance, and therefore this is estimated to be the uniqueness or measurement, and what is uniqueness? That is the error associated to that specific item, and therefore the error sum is nothing but the sum of these three variances. What is shared is actually an estimate of the inter-item variance or what is being explained by the latent constraint. And so this is how we understand these tables, and that is what it means. No, so Vindu, we will not test. So when you see, for the second order, these become your first order, these become your indicators. And therefore, when you will do your composite or ABE testing, we will only use these three loadings. We will not use the first order, because these loadings are actually determining the ABE or CR for EMP. Whereas these loadings are determining the ABE or CR for leadership. So we'll just do it for the second order, these three loadings. We will let these, we have already done this yesterday, and therefore I am not going to do it now. Okay, we'll work with lead, we'll work with PJ, and we'll work with CP. Okay, so you will have to do for second order factor separately. Okay, so I think we are done. We'll stop here.